Thank you so much, guys. Joining me is Niels and amazing indeed. Very first win for Oregon on the LCS stage. Was against Giants, but you guys were really careful going into this match, not wanting to put too much pressure maybe on your old shoulders. And it translated into a quite a quiet early game, so to say. Amazing. Was that getting the jitters out?
Yeah, kind of. Like, we can call it quiet, but honestly, I felt like we didn't play to our usual standard, which is like our scrim standard. So I'm slightly unhappy with the game, but we took the win, and that's at least what counts towards playoffs.
Right, directly being quite, what's the word? A lot of critique for your own play in the very first game. That's good to go into it.
Yeah, basically, like since I'm one of the main shot callers together with Mithy, like I can only critique myself for the play, so I have to work up to that.
That's nice.
It was interesting. Before we came over to us from the caster desk, amazing, you were talking about how people are playing a little bit differently from usual on stage. Niels, it seemed like business as usual, from Challenger Series straight into LCS on Kalista. How was that, your first game as an LCS player?
I mean, to be honest, I think I missed at least 25 CS just in laning phase, and I feel like my mouse was not moving, and I had to grab my own mouse pad from Miffy's because I had no my own with me. So. But after the first 25 minutes, it started to become fine again, and it was like, I felt like at home, you know? But in the other game, I couldn't hit a CS, and I missed every spear, but then after that, it became fine again. So
a little bit of jitters, and then it became fine again. Yet the game, whilst it looked like it was very much going in your favor, in the mid game, there were a couple of trades and team fights that Giants actually did pretty well. And it reminded me of the couple of times where you guys in, I believe it was the semifinals of the Challenger Series, where sometimes you guys had some trouble when it came to the late game and decision making. How did you experience that?
Yeah, you can see the parallels a bit. Like, we had a bit of Langitas coming in, and we kind of let them come back into the game where we shouldn't have. And it was due to us not, like, doing our usual routines, which is basically rotate for every turret, get every Drake, like, set up for everything properly. We were scared to kind of face into pink wards because we gave LeBron Baby too much respect, or Pepinero too much respect, which we shouldn't. And I guess that was it, but... I hope we can adapt tomorrow, at least.
Yeah, I think you mean that he did deserve the respect, but you still got to play your own game, of course.
Yeah, he didn't deserve so much respect, let's put it this way.
All right.
Like, we shouldn't be scared of him, we should respect him as a player, but we shouldn't be afraid of him.
Mm-hmm. I think it was very interesting because Pepinero did, in that game, basically what he did against Elements at the end of last split, which was they weren't getting the fights they wanted. So he just goes, okay, I'm going to go to the other lanes. I'm going to go top. I'm going to go bot. I'm just going to split push. Yeah. Yes, you got one flank on you, Niels, but I actually want to bring things to a replay that we have here. It was slightly earlier in the game. This was one of the team fights just around the lower river where... Giants, maybe this was one of the better setups they could have hoped for. You guys actually engaged onto them, and then from here, one thing that we were tracking throughout this entire game was past 20 minutes, where did the Ash arrows land? Only four were fired after 20 minutes. At this point, you guys have split and kited back really nicely, and every single time an Ash arrow actually came into fights, of the four, two hit Eve, two hit Alistair. That was pretty much perfect from what you guys wanted. I don't believe it actually even locked Mithy down here. From here, it's a really easy re-engage for you guys. After you've seen fights like this happen time and time again, Niels, for you as the AD carry, how do you basically make sure you don't get caught out in these fights? Because look at how low you get bursted down.
I mean, the arrow hits Alistair, who's in the ult, and then the Sylvani ult hits only one guy. So there's no more spells, and the guy will miss too. So there's not so much stuff except for the blank burst that can kill me. So after the initial like ults, you know, then there's nothing else that can kill me. So I can just go in, you know, have Black Shield too in case. And Alistar is very balanced too. So yeah.
Yeah, I mean, on that point, I actually saw, I think it might have been Skara that was tweeting how strong Alistair is right now. So certainly seems the mutual comment from a lot of the players as
definitely
well.
Definitely is. How did you experience also in this game Alistair, but still got to be played correctly? And Mithy just seems to be growing and growing, and you guys together as well.
Yeah, I mean, Mithy teach me a lot about how to play the game on like a competitive stage and like instead of solo queue. And that helped me a lot during our time together. So I appreciate that, of course. And I think we're going to a strong duo, not only like lane phase, but like other side of the game, how we communicate, how we use Kalista ult, for example. Like after his ult is over, he's kind of like one-shotted, so he tells me to ult him in or ult him out. Yeah.
Yeah. One final thing about the game, maybe amazing on Evelynn, something that we've seen risen to popularity again in recent games. Why is it your champion right now?
Is it my champion?
I mean, for this game at least.
Okay,
you can
this
tell
game,
us that. Hashtag ask amazing.
Okay, that glad you bring that up. Anyway, the thing is that I think that Evelynn has like this one factor to her. It's basically like to make the enemy play safe. It doesn't even matter which matchup it is. As soon as Evelynn has red buff and get behind someone and like get on the same level as someone, which is quite easily as Evelynn, you can just walk up to them, not even using W necessarily, just like flanking them. As soon as you're on level with them and you're able to chase with the W and red buff, like it's a 100% kill. And that alone just makes the laning phase so much easier, especially 1v1, 2v2 laning. And her mid to late game scaling is actually pretty good too. So like most of the critique that is coming towards Evelynn is basically that she's able to be bursted maybe if she's caught out. But if you're a smart player, which I hope to be, you shouldn't be caught out and use her strengths correctly.
All right, well, you absolutely did. And you guys got that first win on the board. Good job on that. Stepping back from the game, of course, I got to ask you, I had your two colleagues here, Soaz and Xpeke, asking them about expectations going into the season. You know, Wanna making playoffs is on there. Not aiming too high. You got to see how things go. Maybe you guys are a bit more vocal or have a different opinion. I think so.
Do you want to go?
Niels?
I mean, I know you think we're best team in the world, you know, but I just really just want to see how it goes, you know. Sure, win the first match, but I think there are some really good teams this season, better than last season at least, I mean last bit. So I just want to see how it goes and hope for the best.
Yeah, but with the way you guys know you can play, I mean playoffs should be something that you should be able to get.
Yeah, definitely. For us, like as Pekka already communicated, like playoff is everything basically. And afterwards, it's just like a matter of being in the form. Like we saw Unicorns of Love, they had a pretty bad seed, to be honest. They had their fifth seed, and they came in and basically got second place in the end because just other teams were not in form. They were so just play playoffs, be prepared for that, and that's basically the goal. There is.
Yeah. Well, you got to start somewhere, and with one win is a very good start. Congratulations.
Thank
great
you.
Game by you guys. An important note from us, though, for you guys at home. Due to a logistical issue, we will be making a change to the schedule today. Up next, we'll be bringing you the clash between Gambit Gaming and the new roster of Elements. That will be followed by H2K versus Rocket, and then the Copenhagen Wolves versus SK Gaming. A little bit of a shuffle, but the European LCS continues in just a few minutes.
You want troll or what?
Yeah, I want troll, exactly.
Okay.
So
that's good.
And no one adds troll and we win. Okay?
Yeah.
But the pulverize locks them both up. That's another kill to Origin. Amazing's on the board. The flame spitter puts Soaz on the board. It's still burning him away. Agony's embrace is melting giants on the side lane. It's a 2-for-1 as the glacial prism locks up Origin.
Coming. Calesta.
Evelynn. Rumble.
Kill Evelynn.
Evelynn? Nice.
Was killed by Ignite, but Godfrey is traded in return. Ash Arrow connects there onto Niels, but it simply does not matter. Origen are on the board, taking down Giants.